What's up, guys? Leopold the Brave here, and welcome to my next annual year in review video that I've roped myself into doing every year, even though I don't like doing it because I have trouble rambling for more than 10 minutes. It makes me feel awkward because my brain isn't fast and can't think of things to say, but here we go. So I guess, like always, or if I can recall last time I did this first, let's go over some IRL stuff, some real-life events that happened, because this year was an interesting one. If you remember from last year, I kinda quit my job because I was being discriminated against for my disability and all that blah, and I've been having trouble finding a new one because of the pandemic, and my stomach issues are continuing, and we're also in the process of moving, so there'd be no point in getting one anyways because then I'd just have to immediately quit. So all this crazy IRL events and stuff going on is just kind of making it difficult to go anywhere in life. I'm stuck at the moment, but I will get there. But yes, my stomach issues have persisted. They've gotten a little better, but not much better. But hopefully they continue to improve, and I won't have to do any more procedures or surgeries for them. Please, because I am tired of them. Too many. Meh. But all this extra free time did give me a chance to improve more in my art. I've improved crazy with my digital art this year, and I'm so proud of myself for it. So let me have this one thing. I created a new character that I'm super proud of called Star, the elf lady. You've probably seen her if you follow my Twitter, and if you've seen a couple of my videos on here. I've made her and a bunch of other characters for her world, and I'm coming up with this little story, so we'll see where that goes. I'm just kind of winging it as I go along with them, but I'm super proud of them, and I'm proud of my art, and just super excited with how all that stuff is turning out. I wish I had a lot more to say about events that happened IRL this year, but it was interesting in the fact that there were so many things going on preventing other things that nothing could really happen, and that's what made it interesting, if that makes any sense. See, I'm bad at rambling. Online, though, aside from my art improving, this is actually the year that I quit YouTube. Now, I know it looks like nothing is different on your end. I'm still uploading regularly, pretty much talking about the same things I've always been talking about. But I'm just not really trying. If you've noticed, I'm not exactly on a schedule. There is sometimes week-long gaps, week-and-a-half-long gaps, even two-week-long gaps. I'm just doing things whenever I feel like, taking breaks whenever I feel like, instead of trying to put myself on a schedule like, oh, I gotta make a video once every 4 days or once every 3 days like I used to do. That was really, really stressful worrying about schedules and view counts and promoting my videos, making sure they get out there, blah, blah, blah. So, it's just a lot easier on me to go with the flow, like I've been doing since the second half of last year. Socially, in person, I haven't had a chance to improve in getting past my anxieties and talking to people and meeting new people because, again, pandemic, yeah. But I have been improving online. I've made lots of new friends, gotten to know more people, and it's been super, super good. I love them all. They're super sweet, so I'm happy. Yay. But as far as I'm aware, that's pretty much all I have to say about me and stuff that happened to me this year, everything about me this year. This is like half the amount of time it took last time. That shows you how uneventful it was, because even though I can't drive and go out places anyways, the pandemic still affected me, even though I regularly stay at home most of the time. That's how bad it is. Whoop-de-doo. The games that came out this year and the games I played this year were a really good pick-me-up, though. They helped cheer me up and helped me get through the year. And I already talked about a lot of them in my top 10 games I played in 2020 video, which I made a couple days ago. So be sure to give that a watch if you want to see my thoughts on that. But there were a couple games that I kind of left out, like Among Us. That's an honorable mention for the top 10 list, but didn't make it because it's pretty much entirely dependent on playing with friends. If you ever try to play Among Us solo, you are not going to have a fun time. Ever. It is a dumpster fire. Then there's Jackbox Party Pack 7, which came out this year, which literally cannot be played solo, but it contained one of my favorite games in the entire series, probably my most favorite, Champed Up. You basically draw these little characters based on a prompt, and then other people try to guess what the prompt was based on the character you drew by drawing another character combat them. And so the two characters battle each other out, and people can decide which one is more accurate. And it's just super fun. Then finally, there's GTA Online. I know it's nothing new, and I've been playing GTA for several years, and the game has been out for even longer than that. But I've been doing GTA Online very idly this entire time, like just hopping into free mode and messing around, and then doing stunt races every now and then. I never really got into it until this year. I learned all the business stuff in the business meta, and it was fun to grind it out for a while, and I'm taking a break because I kind of overworked myself because I had nothing better to do. But I'm going to get back into it now that I have everything set up, and money's just going to be flowing in, and I'm going to be able to do and get whatever I want in the game without having to spend a single penny, which I've never done for the game. So that's a little accomplishment I'm proud of. Even though Rockstar is trying to milk everyone who plays the game for all they're worth, they haven't gotten a single thing out of me beyond the initial purchase of the base game. So, take that, Rockstar. As far as animated shows go, we got a pretty good amount of stuff that came out this year. HBO Max started, so we got Close Enough, an adult cartoon from the creator of Regular Show, and it's just as good and just as funny as Regular Show. So hopefully they get more seasons, and I can't wait to see where they go with that. I don't really have too much to say because it literally is just Regular Show for a slightly older audience than it was already intended for. But yeah. Then the Animaniacs reboot also came out this year. I don't think it was as good as the original show, but it's definitely still good. I don't think they're being too political because the original show was already very political, so I don't mind that at all. I just think they're being a lot less subtle and less clever about it. Like, if the Don was president back when the original show was still going, they would have really had at him, like pointing out every single last thing he did wrong and showing it to the entire world, and brilliant comedy. And then here, in the reboot, it's just Orange Man bad jokes. Again, it's still a very good reboot, I just felt like they held back a bit too much on certain things instead of really going after him like they used to. A reboot I'm less pleased with that came out this year were the new Looney Tunes cartoons on HBO Max. They're not bad either, but they're just kind of boring, which I hate to say about the Looney Tunes. Like, the animation is great and fun to watch, but there are, like, barely any good jokes. Instead of the slapstick and comedy being unpredictable and wild based around the environment and the situation the characters are put in, 75% of the time it's just dynamite placed in unsuspecting places. Also, I hate to be the stereotypical redneck keep the guns guy, but them getting rid of Elmer Fudd's and Yosemite Sam's guns was a huge mistake. A lot of the best jokes in the original shorts came from the use of guns, like, would you like to shoot me now or wait till you get home? Shoot him now, that whole bit, and then Wabbit season, Duck season. You could also do a lot more visual comedy with them, like shooting Daffy and then his beak goes spinning around, or it gets turned upside down, or just blows off entirely. What can you do with the sickle that they gave Elmer Fudd now? Stab him? Cut him? Yeah. If anything, that's more violent. So yeah, while the new Looney Tunes shorts were animated beautifully, they just were not funny to me. I'm sorry. As for animated movie news, I have a few notable things to talk about, like the new SpongeBob SquarePants movie Sponge on the Run, which is so hilariously bad and boring. Like, to the point where me and my friends had a whole movie night where we just made fun of it the entire time. It was lots of fun. There was The Croods 2, A New Age, or Dawn of a New Age, or whatever it was called. I need to watch it again because I just watched it once, and it was a fever dream. I'll be talking about that soon. Yeah. And then there was Soul. I really, really liked it when I first saw it, except for the ending. I just felt it was a little unsatisfying. But the more I thought about it, the less and less I liked it. It's just sort of mid. Like, it's one of Pixar's more mature movies, but there are lots of elements where they're still trying so hard to appeal to the younger kids and audiences and getting them to watch it. And there are lots of things in it that remind me of Inside Out, which I'm also not a huge fan of. Like, in Inside Out, the entire landscape is just this pink brain area with a few things sticking out of it that they go to. It's not really a big and creative-looking world. Same thing happened with Soul. The Great Before, it's just this empty field of purple and blue, and these little huts that the souls go into to get their personalities, like that's creative or something, like, this is where personalities come from, but they just go into a hut and come out. I was just like, okay. And then this is how souls go to Earth, they literally just jump in an Earth hole. I did like the message that the movie gave overall, but I just don't think they went hard enough with it. That pretty much sums up all my thoughts on how animation went this year. Animation was great this year, but not super fantastic. There were no masterpieces. They didn't go hard enough. They were kind of scared and held back a little. Hopefully this year, though, that changes and they actually go for it and give some truly incredible and inspiring stories. But that about rounds up my thoughts for everything that's been going on in 2020, both in entertainment and media and my personal life and my online life and stuff I'm working on like art and YouTube videos. It was pretty uneventful, but the things that did happen were pretty okay. So, here's to a better year this year. Let's see if 2021 is exciting and fun. And I'll see you guys next time. LeopoldTheBrave out.